building on Fifth Avenue with the doorman from hell and that beady-eyed neighbor in the lobby?
Nikolai? Oh, he's not half bad for a Euro trash gigolo.
That woman he was with had to be twice his age. I mean, I actually heard him call her Mummy.
Well, she did adopt him.
That element. Between you and me, I've seen livelier faces at Madame Tussauds.
Are you saying I live in the waxworks, like Sunset Boulevard?
I wouldn't go that far.
I'm still big. It's the music that got small. Laugh. I'm having fun with you.
It's not always easy to tell. I'm glad I got you out.
There goes my reputation as a recluse. Anyway, what's the point of being reclusive when the public doesn't even notice you've gone? Did my watch stop?
You realize a restoration like this normally takes days.
Normality is one vice I've managed to avoid. Would you like some more strudel?
I think I have maybe six types of toxic chemicals on my hands. It's delicious.
Well, it will help you forget those cunning little white gelatinous cubes we had at dinner.
Tofu. My wife is into macrobiotics this month.
The happy homemaker?
I wouldn't say that.
She isn't happy?
Well, she isn't a homemaker. She's a composer. Well, aspiring. She studied with Mr. Chesky.
Vladimir? He was quite the ladies' man in his day. Vlad the Impaler, we called him.
He was 90 years old, on a walker. She's very talented. Her cello composition won a national contest.
It's funny that didn't come up at dinner.
Oh, no, it wouldn't. She's very modest, and you're kind of...
Not.
Well, your resume can be a bit...
intimidating. Tell me, how did you finally familiarize yourself with my intimidating past?
The internet.
You're rather exposed.
A sonority of tone.
Ah, yes, New York Times. My Carnegie Hall debut. Critics like to point out my tone. Wasn't always a compliment.
I guess they thought that for a woman.
Wasn't ladylike? Oh, to hell with that. I've always had a big tone. I'm an old-fashioned romantic. Ah, these young musicians today treat a violin like it was a porcelain figurine, as if it would crash into a thousand pieces at the merest touch. Where I come from, violin is first a folk instrument. No pampering. Play it loud over the noisy crowd. Pour yourself into every note, and the notes will come back like a thunderclap. Play it like you mean it. Oh, the time.
If you're that worried, my wife can take you to the station.
Without the Dapadoff? No, that's impossible. But I might be persuaded to spend the night.
I don't think you'd much like the convertible sofa. Plus, I've got to take the boys to the orthodontist first thing. Braces, both of them. What I need. Oh, the dog's overdue for deworming.
Such an abundant life. Here I am underfoot.
Where would you like it?
Oh, God!
Watson, that must be your new bride.
Well, she's not exactly new, George.
I know what you mean, Mr. Sanderson. Very few of them are nowadays. I'm liberal-minded, though, so what the heck?
Jen, this is George.
Pleased to meet you.
You'll have your hands full there.
So, when was the wedding?
What wedding?
But I thought...
Oh, we've been married for 6 years.
6 years?
We just haven't been together for a while.
Oh, I see. Well, is everything all right here?
Yeah, fine.
That's still a bit dusty, ain't it?
I can always feel it. It dries the mouth right out. Yes, sir. Very dry.
Oh, would you like something to drink, George?
Oh, the coffee is ready.
Oh, coffee. My doctor says I can't drink coffee. Too stimulating, you know.
Hot chocolate?
It brings me out in a rash.
Would you have some whiskey?
Now you're talking. Not too much. Just a small mug would be fine. Yep, it's a good old house. Solid. No leaks or nothing. I bought it a few years back from my boy Robert, but he's not too keen on farming, so I just rents it out. Yep, I think you'll enjoy it here. The last one sure did. They'd still be here now if it weren't for the ghosts.
The ghosts?
Yeah, I don't believe in them myself, Mrs. Sanderson, but these were city folks, and they read too many books.
What ghosts?
Well, about 50 years ago, there was a ghastly murder took place in this very room. It was a young woman about your age.
What was that?
Greg, there was a murder committed in this very room.
A long time ago.
How fascinating.
I hope you folks don't believe in ghosts.
No. The only thing I believe in is science. To me, a ghost is just a chemical in someone's brain.
Well, I'm glad you feel that way. This house has scared off a lot of people over the years. It's the ghosts that scare them mainly. And the blood.
Blood?
Well, there's a red stain that appears on the floor. It was this young woman, they say. They found her body right there, lying in a pool of blood. They say that whenever there's murder around these parts, that the floor turns red.
Who murdered her?
Well, the story goes like this. There was this hermit who lived up where the quarry is now. He was deformed, quite grotesque, apparently. I guess that's why he became a hermit. Well, the farmer who lived here sold the mining rights to this company that wanted to start quarrying up there, but the old hermit wouldn't move, so they drove him off. But that very night, he crept back, forced open that window, and stabbed the farmer's daughter to death right in this very room, just before midnight.
Did they ever catch you?
No, they never did. But a lot of folks around here claim they've seen.
Well, surely he must have died long ago.
This is his ghost that people see. They say you should never go up to the quarry at night, and you should never stay in this house. Shouldn't be telling you that, should I?
The show. Come on. You said you had a show. Well, have you read that?
Pal Joey by John O'Hara.
Kind of racy, isn't it?
Yeah, you might say we're skirting the edges of decency a little.
Oh, is that what you call it? My mother would call this a dirty book.
Read it. The rights are nailed, and there's a star role for your good pal Vivian Ross.
We're going to an opening tonight. I will let her know.
I already told her. And there's one we started to write for that Greek goddess parody, you remember? I think it's got a place in this show. You remember,
Yes, we had a title and half the song worked out. Yeah. If they asked me, I could write a poem.
Then that's the one.
Right, well then we got it nailed. I will get to work on this tonight. You will get it tomorrow, Friday, at the very latest.
Fine, but I want you to use this pencil, the one over here.
Why? Why? Because with this pencil, the song is going to write itself?
Maybe try it, you'll see why.
Just looks like an ordinary pencil to me. Dick! Dick! Not funny. Dick.
When you're finished, wave the pencil and the door will magically open.
Don't be an idiot. I have an appointment at the tailor's.
Put your finished work under the door, first. You want me to hum the tune again?
No! Goddamn magic pencil remembers it.
If they asked me, I could write a book about the way you walk and whisper and look. I could write a preface on how we met so the world would never forget.
Right here.
This'll do. Keep going.
You're a little dictator. You know that you should be leading Germany.
And the simple secret of the plot is just to tell them that I love you. A lot.
Here.
I love this a lot. It kills me how quick you can be when you want. It just goddamn kills me.
All right, the rest I can do at home.
Finish.
Something, something is my book, and something, something, something that rhymes with ends.
Okay, fine, I will fill in the rest later. Will
you fill it in now.
Let me out!
Fill in the something, something.
Come. What are some more book words? A chapter, pages, a prologue.
Leather binding.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G. I never learned to spell. At least not well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I never learned to count a great amount. But my busy mind is burning to use what learning I've got. I won't waste any time. I'll strike while the iron is hot.
If they asked me, I could write a book about the way you walk and whisper and look.
I could write a preface on how we met
so the world would never forget. And the sin. like this.
Think about what your grandma was like. budget, Grandma. Yes. Got a clear picture in your head. Yes. Rotten, wasn't she?
Ma!
Well?
Your own mother?
Who better to say? Now, I'm going to tell you this the one time, so you'll understand. The next Saturday, I'll go to confession because I had these thoughts or said these words in 20 years. Honey, that woman was mean. From as early as I can remember, nasty. 3, 4 years old I was, and she would flick my ears whenever I wasn't looking. She, what? For no reason, drove me crazy. Finally, I had to wear earmuffs all year round. She used to call me Muffy. What came down to was, she didn't like me. I don't know why, but that's how it was, and I lived with it. Told myself, okay, so other people got nice mothers. Lucky them, so what? I got a nice father, nice husband, good kids. That's plenty for me, I'm satisfied. And my kids, they'll never have to go through what I did with that. With that unhappy woman. So, what I'm saying is this. That's exactly the kind of lousy thing your grandma went and done. Tell you that story at the last minute to make us think bad about your grandfather. Let's stick her to the very end. Get in that last flick.
Well, maybe that's true, Ma. But there is something else Grandma told me about that if you saw it, it might change your mind about things. Ma, the statue's face. She's pretty, right?
Sure, very pretty.
Yeah, everyone said so. When the statue was delivered and they opened the packing crate, everyone said the same thing. Oh, how pretty. All except Grandma. Know what Grandma said? Mue Boja Taona. My God, it's her, Isabel. The sculptor, Ma, how do you do it? How do you make the statue look like Isabel when Isabel wasn't there for him to look at? She was back in Poland. How do you do it?
That is the face of the Blessed Mother.
Is it? Ma, what there was a photograph, a picture of Isabel. Grandpa let the sculptor use it as a guide.
Now, how do you know that? Because Grandma said.
She said?
She saw the picture.
She said she saw. Yes, one night Grandpa was sneaking a look at it and she caught him.
Oh, God, I'm sneaking a bee.
Yes.
So where is it?
Well, he hid it. They had a big fight about it, he hid it here somewhere.
No, sweetie, there is no picture.
Just because I don't have it doesn't mean
it has a description of Bigfoot Weekly.
There is no picture of Isabel. We wouldn't have come across it. How many times have Ma and I cleaned this house? When we had the exterminators in?
Look, how many times?
They had us tear this whole place apart.
It's not in the house.
I'm sorry, sis, but you brought us all here for nothing.
The picture's not in the house.
The statue's the statue of the Blessed Mother, just like it always was.
The picture's not in the house! Grandpa would have kept a picture of Isabel with Isabel in the shrine! It's in the shrine!
Oh, don't you go busting up that statue! I'll slap those two. Oh, be gentle with her, she's a virgin!
That's why this lady is a tramp.